Yo, what's going on everyone? It's time for another spoilers video. It seemed that the last one did okay and didn't actually annoy anybody by the spoilers that was chosen. I've done the same again. Hopefully we have the same reaction. I haven't seen any of these photos yet, but before we get into that, we have some new news as well that we should touch on first, so anyone that doesn't want to get spoiled can obviously leave and we'll get the news first. So of course, as we know from last week, that we're going to have an announcement that there was going to be a color page for each of these four chapters. Obviously this is going to be now chapter two, and we have the spoilers for that. So here it is on screen. Noelle, Nini, good choice, Kubo, as per usual. It seems he's going for a different art style here, and it was even questioned by a friend of mine on whether this was Kubo's art style or not. And I can understand where he is coming from. Kubo has been able to replicate many different art styles, and he's gone for a Moe art style in this one. I can tell that it is he's going by his line work and by his, usually his mouth features of how he usually draws mouths and noses and facial structures in general. But he also has the Moe appearances of like the very flat colors, as well as like not completely connecting the lines, especially within the hands here. Either or, whether you want to say it's Kubo or not, it is. You know, the translations do say it is. His credits are right there as well on the color page. It is Kubo's, and especially his background coloring as well. It is his. So, you know, I don't really want that to really be the discussion, really, of this color page. But, however, it looks great. It's Pi Day. I'm all about it. I don't know what else to say. It's visually appealing. It looks great. It's cute as fuck. Nini, he looks beautiful. I don't know why Noelle always tries to act like she's elegant, when in fact she's just a raging weeb, and that's just how it is. Like, I love how she's like the calm and collective one of the group, but you know she's just equally as like just as dumb as Nini is. So it's nice. I like how, and I can actually understand their balance of banter, their balance of friendship, because they actually see more than meets the eye compared to their appearance, which looks like the completely polar opposite. So look, Nini just proves why she's girlfriend material, because I would rather prefer a girlfriend to dress like that in casual, comfy clothing than prim and proper like Noelle. But hey, you guys do you. I ain't got no issue with Noelle. She's gorgeous, beautiful, and yeah, look at him. Great. It's great to see. I wonder if we're ever going to have a color page with Bargo on it. And no, like, yeah, we did technically have the last one with Bargo, but, you know, seeing the two girls is more important, I would say. And yeah, I've got really nothing more to say on this other than 34 pages, and this says chapter 2, basically. We then followed up with the newspaper of Reverse London, called the Reverse London Press. There you go. And basically, the first half of this this page just shows that there's going to be an Osushi dog plushie to which you can buy. The translations basically say it has a zip, and basically that's it. It's very comfortable. It's super soft. It has, like, some reviewers saying, oh, it's so soft, and then it just says when it's coming out and how much it's going to be. It's going to be 4,180 yen, which is going to be like £30, $40. I don't know. It's pretty pricey, I would personally say, but the quality does look banging, to be honest with you. So, with that being said, we then go straight onto some anime news, which is going to be the four character actors or voice actors for these specific characters, which I've forgotten the names of already. For Bruno, for Sullivan, and for Roy B. Dripper. I forgot who the Wolfenstein, I forgot his name. But thankfully, I do have these voice actors written out. I got them translated. So Wolfgang, the first guy that you see, the one that looks like Ocelot from Metal Gear Solid. And I think someone also said on my Discord as well, which if you haven't followed, there's a link in the description. So go check out the Discord for early news and discussions and stuff like that as well. Someone said that actually this voice actor was involved in Metal Gear. I haven't double checked that, but I'll just take his word for it. Wolfgang /Hort is the first guy that you see. His voice actor is, and I'm gonna butcher these names, but there is gonna be a comment section about these characters, so you can copy and paste the names and you can look at their respective roles from the past. But he's been played by Mugihito. Bruno is going to be played by Chikahiro Kobayashi. Sullivan is going to be voice acted by Haruka Shimizu, which I think is maybe the most recognizable out of these. And Roy B. Dripper is going to be played by Mao Tanaka. So there you go. There's going to be a link, not a link, but like the character names will be in the description or comment section, depending on what you guys prefer below. So with that being said, cool, we got that. And other than that, we also have the table of contents, if you want to call it that. Table of contents basically gives you a preview of what's happening for next week's volume, which basically says for Burn the Witch here is that there is going to be more anime news next week, which is expected. We're probably going to get more about the other voice actors of the governments that we saw from the last chapter. This one is basically saying that we're going to have 32 pages for the next chapter, which it's progressively getting less and less and less. I'm hoping, so this is chapter 3, so I'm hoping chapter 4 will have a bigger number, because it just makes sense. It's the last chapter, so they want to make the last chapter a big one. So yes, chapter 3 will be 32 pages long, and there's going to be some anime news next week. So as expected, I would say, and probably some more merch. So of course, if you want to get the news first, and I mean first because I pay for it, go to my Twitter account and you can get the leaks of any news firsthand. But with that being said, let's jump on to list spoilers. So here we go. The first image out of the 7 that I have at the moment is the title cover page. This one was included by me, other than the guy that usually goes and checks them, because I feel like this is just a chapter page. It's not going to be really spoily at all. This one's called Gilisu, even though I don't see the correlation here. But it is from the promo that Shueisha gave us not so long ago with the music. Again, if you don't follow me on Twitter, you will know what I'm talking about. But yeah, there was a promo for the music video, and it shows these two character designs as a whole. So it seems like to me that each of the as the weeks go on, like Shueisha will give these little manga movie videos or music videos that will kind of be used to promote, and they'll be used in very specific panels to those specific videos. So here we go, this one, color page. Nini is just giving like the Yakuza look, which is cool, and Noelle just has the same blank expression as per usual. And you guys waifu this girl? For what? For what? Looks? Oh, you guys capping. But I was about to say, I thought the guns were a little bit different because they look like spheres, but no, it's just the butt of the gun. But yeah, nothing too much to talk about here. They look exactly the same as per usual. So, on to the next page, shall we? Okay, so starting off, it seems like we're in a convenience store or building. Nini's literally just making a grand entrance with her dragon. Obviously, I can't read Nihongo, so yeah. So something's obviously kicking off from what I gather. If Nini's in a situation like this where she's rushing into a scenario, whether it be a battle or an incident, I don't know. Yeah, she's rushing in. Seems like stuff's about to kick off. I don't know. Okay, maybe I'll get more context in the other pages. Okay, being thrown with another character design, it seems. And I'm going to make a shout that Nini's probably going to be fighting this person, because it seems like her dragon, or a dragon. Then again, if you was a civilian and Nini was helping you, you wouldn't be that shocked. Yeah, because like this, yeah. So it looks like she's shocked more than anything, like that it's going to be her dragon. It wouldn't be a random dragon or a pet. That looks like one of the dragons that they use. Let me have a look through these pages. Hang on. Okay, so this is an introduction. So I was shooting for the fact that this might be one of the government members, but I actually don't recognize her from any of the... Unless... No. Wait, what was the name? What was the name of the research and development person that was vacant? It was like Saka? Saka, was it? That sounds like a male name, so she's a new character. She's a completely new character. Okay, so is this going to be the main villain of the arc? I wonder. We shall see. The character design alone, though, I wouldn't say she looks like a filler character. She just has like one of those hairstyles which, like, you know, you're not going to last for long. Like, you kind of look like you're just a draft character, if that makes sense. And to be fair, I don't know. It's 4 chapters, mate. What can I say? But like, this character doesn't pop out to me. Clothing, looks normal. I don't know, this yeah, like this character isn't popping out to me, so I assume she's going to be the main focus of this chapter though. So next one is that Vargo with the fucking Pipers, yeah, the Pipers uniform, mate. Did he get, okay, so like the last chapter he still has the collar, lol, he still has the collar on and he's happy. Nini is kind of just looking very blank expressed right now. Oh wait, does he have his own horn? He has a horn, not a wand. Is that a wand or a horn? It looks like a horn. Like, interesting. So, here's my... no, seriously, on his shoulder. That's adorable. Okay, so, I'm going to... because last chapter that we saw that, obviously, the government weren't pleased with Bargo. And they were going to take action. Is this their way of getting Bargo closer to them? Or keeping him more under control? Or is this before they've taken action and he's getting promoted into some rank or something like that? Why is he being thrown into the Pipers for? Does he have any kind of skills? Can he do the spells that Nini and Noelle can do? This is interesting because it can go two ways. One, he's able to, he's been promoted by the organization, or the other hand is that the government are trying to like get him closer. Why would they make him up? Okay, that's interesting. That's a very interesting panel right there. Okay. Oh, so this wench is batshit crazy. You love to see. Okay. Do you know what? I vibe a little bit. Okay. She's lobbing a desk. Yo, this is a good panel. I actually like this because in the other ones, she looks kind of blank faced. The first one, like she looked vexed because, yeah, this is clearly, I'm going to say this is who Nini's fighting. This is very clear to me. It's got to be, surely, right? So Nini's fighting this girl. She obviously nay-nayed her dragon, I would assume. And yeah, she's not happy about it. Yeah, I think that's going to go. And the okay. Whoa, okay, yeah. Well done. Well done, Yubi. Well done. Wow, okay. Is this at the start or at the end of the chapter? Okay, so... this is our last spoiler page, so soak it in, everybody. This is Noelle. This is Noelle. Yeah, fan service. Good old Cubes. That's interesting. She looks so different with, like... I mean, wait, let's have a look at the colour page right quick. I want to look at the colour page. So, like, usually her hair is, like, usually pulled back. So this one's just, like, kind of free-flowing. And you know what? Ooh, I don't know what I prefer, actually. They both look good. However, Kubo, you know what you did? You know what you did? You evil man. You evil man. She's watering plants, she's drinking water, so she's keeping herself hydrated like a good girl. And the dragon that she, I believe that's the one she rides on, is giving her a newspaper. I'm going to assume this is just her daily morning routine. So it's very questionable whether this is at the start of the chapter or at the end of the chapter, but she's got a very interesting... So hang on, is this her London house or is this her... No, this is going to be her reverse London house. So does she have two homes to go to? It's very interesting how Noelle's life runs, to be honest. Like, what do her parents do? Are her parents normal? Does she have a house there? Does she have her own place in reverse London? If so, what does she tell them when she is like not at home for like an entire night? That's very interesting to me. Like, how does Noelle's life run? And I hope that by this panel alone that we actually get more exposition on that, because I would love to see that. And it'd be great for the review too when I actually come to read it and I do the review. It'd be good on Kubo's part to explain these characters more and go in depth in more. So I can understand why these chapters are actually longer than the majority of your 19, 20 page chapters, and these are going for like 40s and 30 page chapters, because there's a lot of information to give these characters. And the problem is that, like, even though Noelle and Nini are already good as characters and people are enjoying them so far, I guess the worry is that, are the other characters going to get love like Noelle and Nini? Obviously not, but like, are we going to care about them? Are they going to be given enough backstory for us to understand who they are? And it seems he's focusing more on Noelle and Nini, which again, I'm not complaining about, but I'm very interested to see how Cooper is going to pull this off in maybe in this chapter or the next two chapters. But it seems to me that this main chapter is going to be about showing a bit of Noelle's life and just maybe introducing this new villain, who they are, and then it's going to be a fight with Nini and maybe Noelle. So I don't know. This is going to be interesting. Other than that, tell me your guys' thoughts on the comment section down below. Was this too much spoilers? Was this an okay amount of spoilers? Did it get you hyped for the next chapter? And what's your interpretation of all this? What do you think's going down? And anything that I miss? Other than that, what are your thoughts on the color page? What are your thoughts on Burn the Witch so far? Are you really enjoying it? If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button. If you're already subscribed, unsubscribe and resubscribe because YouTube is being silly. Hit that like button and please, please, please go check out the Discord. And if you want to see the live reaction unedited, please go take some time to go check out the Patreon. Other than that, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been handsome as always, people. Peace out.